In this tutorial, we will learn about Dimension Style Manager in detail. At first, we will place one dimension. Now, this dimension is not properly visible. To make it properly visible, give the Dimension Style command. Keyboard shortcut for Dimension Style is D, Enter, then Modify, Fit, and increase the scale here. Use overall scale of. As you increase the scale, the size of the dimension will increase, and if you reduce the scale, size of dimension will reduce. You click on OK and close. Now your dimensions are visible properly. This is the one method. Other method is you can place the dimensions using annotative dimension style. To choose the annotative dimension style, click on this annotation and from here select annotative dimension style. Then place the dimension. To increase the size of this dimension, click here and change the scale. As you change the scale, the size of dimension will change. In this way, you can use the annotative dimension style to control the size of the dimension. Then to change the other parameters of dimension style, click here on annotation and click here. Dimension style. I will change the parameters of the standard dimension style. Click on modify. Click on these lines. Dimension is made of different objects. The side lines of the dimension are called extension lines. The line with arrow is called dimension line, then arrow and text. You can make the setting of all these elements from this dialog box. We will see some of the important at first. Now here it is a setting of the extension lines, and here is one parameter is there, extend beyond dim lines. That means from this arrow, this line is coming out by some distance. That distance you can specify from here. If I increase this value, the length of this line is increased. The other parameter is offset from origin. This is the gap between this extension line and the object. Here the gap is changed. Then click on this symbol and arrows. From here you can control the type of arrow. What you want, a dot or architectural tick or open arrow, or maximum times closed field arrows are used. From here you can define different arrow for leader also. From here you can change the arrow size. Then click on text. From here you can change the style of the text. And by clicking on these three dots, you can change the font. And you can create new style and apply that to dimension. Then from here you can control the text height. Then in text placement, in vertical you can make it above, so that dimension will come above the dimension line. It is changed only for horizontal dimension. It has not changed for inclined or vertical dimension. To change to other, you can click on this align with dimension line. So it will change to all the other dimensions. Now all the dimension has become aligned to the dimension line, but I don't want this radius dimension to be aligned with dimension line. I want this radius dimension to be horizontal. To make it horizontal, click on this ISO standard. That means it is a combine of horizontal and align with dimension line. Then click on this fit. Now for radius, this line is not shown. If you want to show this line, click here, draw dim line between extension lines. Click on this primary units. From here you can change the unit. If you want feet inches, you can select this engineering. It will show the dimension in feet inches. We'll show it in decimal. And if you want to show it mm centimeter meter, then you will have to choose this decimal option. From here you can control the precision. Suppose I want it precision up to 2 digits. Using the decimal separator, you can change the decimal separator from here. You can give it comma or a space or dot. If you want to write something before the dimension, you can write it here in the prefix trial space. So it will write it before the dimension. And if you want to write after the dimension, suppose I want to write it soft, it will write it after the dimension. And if there are some trailing or leading zeros are there, you can suppress them using this option. Now there are these zeros are there. I don't want these zeros. Click here, zero suppression trailing. Okay, close. It will remove the extra zeros. From here you can change unit of the angle. You can choose the desired unit. From here you can control the precision for the angle unit. So it is showing two zeros. If you don't want to show these zeros, but if some number is there, you want to show those number only, then you can click on this zero suppression trailing. So it will not show the zero, but if some number is there, it will show it. Then using this alternate unit, you can place dimension in one more unit near this existing dimension. To show the alternate unit, click here on display alternate units. And from here, you can choose the unit, which unit you want to display. I want to display in feet inches. I will choose this engineering. Then here you will have to give the multiplier of alternate unit. That means by multiplying by which factor it will generate this value. This value is in mm. To convert it into inch, I will have to divide 1 by 25.4 and I will have to multiply this mm by this value. I will just copy it and I will just paste it. Whatever value is generated will be in the inch. For inch also you can use the zero suppression, and from here you can decide the location of the alternate unit. You can place it after the primary value or below the primary value. Then from here you can place the tolerance values. Suppose I want to place it deviation. Then from here you can give the precision. I want it in 3 digit. Then give the upper value. Suppose upper value is 0001 and lower value is 0002. From here you can define the scaling for height. Normally we give the tolerance values in smaller text than the original text, that you can achieve using this scaling for height. Suppose I want it to in 0.5 scale, that is half of the size of the original text. Normally we place the tolerance text above the dimension. From here you can give the position. It is on the top. Then using this tolerance alignment, you can align the operational symbols. That is, it will align this plus and minus, or you can also align the decimal points. Give the enter, modify, then click on this align decimal separators. Okay, close. It will align the decimal points. And if you are using alternate unit, you can define the alternate unit tolerance from here. If we make it active, then it will become active. And from here you can control the alternate unit tolerance precision. Then if you want to give some specific colors to dimension line, from here you can choose the color for dimension line. From here you can choose the line type and line width. By using this baseline spacing, we can give the gap for the baseline dimension. You can suppress the dimension line 1, it will remove it, and dimension line. From here you can give different color for extension line. Same way you can give the line type and line width. You can suppress the extension line from here or bring it back. And you can also give the fixed length extension line by ticking on it. It will give the extension line of fixed length. Then tick on OK and close. It will show the dimension as per our new setting. That's all. Thanks for watching. We will stop here.